Right now, we're going to have a look at a really useful new feature in Photoshop to help us manage our layers. So at the time of this recording, it's only available in the Photoshop beta. To get beta, simply go up to your Creative Cloud icon, go to Apps, and then you'll see beta. And from here, you'll see the Photoshop beta, which you can download. And you can have both the beta and the shipping version of Photoshop installed at the same time. When you launch it, make sure you're running the beta, which you'll see there. And if you're British, you might be calling this beta. That's fine. So I'm going to use this very simple example to show you how this works, and then we'll look at an actual image and how it would work in production, along with a couple of my suggested ways of using it to be more efficient. So this is building off an existing feature in Photoshop called Auto Select. So if we turn Auto Select on, make sure you're in layer and not group. And what happens is as we roll over these, notice in the layers panel, they can be selected. So the first option is not new. Let's go into the gear and we're going to turn on Show Transform Controls. And this means whichever layer is selected, we'll see the bounding box, which means we can drag it and we can adjust it. Here's the regular version of Photoshop, auto select layer. It used to live here. Exactly the same control, except it now lives under this gear. But there's three new options. Let's look at the new options. The first one is show layer bounds on hover. Let me select the background so none of the layers are selected. So as I roll over, notice that these layers are going to show selected. Also look in the layers panel. You can see they're highlighted in the layers panel as well as they are here. Now, if I have auto select turned on, all I need to do is just click when I see the layer I want, and now it's a selected layer. I don't use this option for a reason, and we'll get into this later on. Okay, notice though, when I'm over the square, it's a little bit hard to see, so we can adjust the way this views. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. So let's go to the preferences. Let's go under Photoshop Settings, and then we're gonna go down to the Guides Grid and Slices. So let's click Hover Layer Bounds. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click here and we're going to set this for 3 pixels. Now we could change the color here. So the panel is what you see in the layers panel. It shows light blue and the line color. We could make it anything we wanted. Let's make it yellow just to really make it stand out. Click OK. Now, as I roll, notice that those bounds now show in yellow. And notice now it's thicker and it's easier to see what is selected. All right, let's look at the next option. If I go in the layers panel, notice nothing happens. It just acts like the regular layers panel. But what if we want this behavior to work in the layers panel as well? Well, let's go under the gear, and then we're gonna look at the last option, show hover bounds from layers. So we're gonna turn this on. Everything is still gonna work the same here, but notice now as we go in the layers panel, and as we roll over those layers, now they're going to show on the document. So it works both ways now. Okay, so there's one other option. Expand layer group on click. Well, what does this do? Let me show you. So I put these into a group. I'm going to select all three of these layers. I'll click the bottom one, hold the shift key, click the top. And I'm just going to hit Control G and put these into a group. So here they are nested inside this group or a folder if you prefer to call it that. So as we roll over here, notice we can't see in the layers panel what's being selected. I can click on it. And we still can't see because it's hidden inside this group. So right now we've got a very simple example, so it's not really that inconvenient. But what if you're working a multi-layer document when you've got adjustment layers and all kinds of things going on? You really want to see what's happening. So I could expand the group if I wanted. And now as I roll over, I can see inside the group. Well, what if I don't want to have to click here to expand it? What if I want to automatically do it in the document? That's what this second option does. Expand layer group on click. So we turn that on. Notice that group's contracted. Now watch what happens. As soon as I click on a layer, it will just open that group, and now I can see what I'm working on. So when you're working with multiple groups, this is useful. Couple of things to be aware of. So here's the thing. When you have auto select turned on, when you can just click and drag, and everything works like it would in Illustrator. But notice that I went to grab that triangle, and I accidentally grabbed that square because they're overlapping, and it's easy to do that sometimes. So let me hit the escape key. What I prefer to do is not have auto select turned on. Notice as I hover, you can still see which layers I'm hovering over, but if I click, they don't become selected. Well, let's say I have selected that one and I try to select a different one. Notice it will not select. So I like to have complete control over this and not accidentally select the wrong layer. So what I like to do is roll over, and I can see that the triangle layer is selected. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down the control key on Mac. That would be command on Windows. And now I can click to select it. Notice as I hit that modifier key, it actually toggles this check mark on temporarily. So I like to just hold down that control or command key. Now I can click on the layers I want. I can click that layer. I can move it. And by using that keyboard shortcut, it gives me more control, and I don't accidentally select layers that I don't want to select. All right, so here we are in an actual real image, and I want to show you a couple of interesting things. So notice I've got tons and tons of layers here. And if I roll over some of the different layers, I want to select, say, for example, the woman. Notice I can't. And the reason I can't is because I've got this big gradient here. Even though I have it locked, it still sees this as the layer that I'm hovering over, and it can't see the layers underneath. Now, there's a couple of workarounds. One of them is I can right-click. I can see the layer names, and I could select maybe the character, and now I could move that around. That's one way of doing it. And notice we've got those bounding marks turned on. If I turn off the control handles, we won't see it there, but let's leave those on for now. So what if I want to be able to select these layers underneath? Here's another trick. If you hit the bracket key, notice as I hit that bracket key, I can cycle through different layers that are under my cursor. So if I hit that bracket, we can cycle through the layers, and we can say, there's the layer there, and I can just click here to select it. Now, typically you could control or command click to select that layer. But right now there's a bug in the beta. If you command click or use the auto select and you try to do it the bracket key, it will crash Photoshop. So I'm sure they're going to fix that pretty soon. Okay, so here's something to be careful of. If this auto select is set to group, even though the hover layer is going to show me the layers within the group, if I try to select that individual layer, it will not. It will only select the group. If you're in group, you're only going to be able to select that group and not accidentally nudge or move any of the layers within there. If you want to have control over the individual layers, change it from group to layer. Now you can grab a layer and move it. So I'm curious if this is a feature that you find useful and you're going to use. Let me know in the comments underneath. And if you're new to the cafe, welcome. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.